Signifies the mystical union between Christ and the church. Our Savior Jesus' first miracle was at the wedding at Cana of Galilee. So we invoke your presence, Father, and ask you to send the Holy Spirit to be over this sacred moment in Jesus' name. Amen. My scripture reading, most familiar to many of you, is taken from 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, and I'll be reading for your hearing verses 4 through 8. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but it rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Love never fails. Amen. Robin and Patrice, I'm going to ask you three questions before you do your personal vows. And you're going to respond if you agree. We promise. Robin and Patrice, do you promise to honor and love each other always?
We promise.
Do you promise to share all that you acquire as a couple to continue to build and intertwine your lives together?
We promise.
Do you promise to continue to respect each other's individual qualities, even as you join as a couple, remembering that it's those individual qualities that drew you to each other? At this time, Robin and Patrice will share their personal vows to one another.
Everyone can sit.
Please be seated.
Yeah, sorry.
Thank you.
So I wrote mine down because I was in a rush and I couldn't remember it. Okay. I am Patrice Anthony Davis. Can you hear me?
Not really.
A little bit louder.
Not really.
Not really.
I can talk louder.
That's
a whole concern. Take me, Robin Monique Shelton, as my wife. To honor, to respect, and love. I promise to continue to grow together and try my hardest. You are worth everything. You have entered my life right at the time when I needed you the most. You loved me when I didn't know love myself. Loved me when I barely knew myself. You have not only witnessed, but remained by my side. You are my diamond, my rock, my lifeline, my love. I love you, I love you, I love you. And I vow to be the same for you as you have been for me.
I promise
to be all
the
more.
Ready? Can you stop that?
So I just want to start by saying that we were two. From the first year we got together till now, we've been through countless situations. 11 years and we are finally getting married. You are my teenage brother. And I'm so proud of the person you've become in this relationship, and I'm so proud that you have accepted me of all my flaws. You are the love of my life, like Brian Kirkland said. I've known this since the day I cried to my mom because you wouldn't talk to me at the age 16. She was in front of the building with her friends and, you know, talking to smack, and I was just crying in front of my friends, and you don't usually run to your parents to tell them what's going on in relationships. But I knew that I didn't want to lose you, so I had to go talk to someone. And I talked to my mom at the age of 16 about you. And she just told me to go to her and try to get the truth out. I vow to be a better person in every aspect of our life. I'm not perfect, not even close. And I'm so grateful that I have someone to share my imperfections with. Someone who takes me and doesn't judge who I am or what I've done. I can't say that all the time, but I love you. But someone who sees what I want to have is a future with them, and they want to have the same thing. It's like I'm falling in love all over again. I found my soulmate 11 years ago, and we've been wanting it out ever since. I vow to protect your heart, body, soul, was all I have in you. I vow to show you that I have everything that you need. I will have everything that you need if I don't have it now. And I promise to do everything that I have.
with one hand on upper garden. Bless, O Lord, these rings, that she who gives it and she who wears it may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor until their life's end. In the name of Jesus, amen. Patrice and Robin today are here to join their lives together. These two separate vases of sand symbolize their separate lives before you found each other. They symbolize your separate friends, family, and choices. Today, both of you will seal your bond by blending these two individual vases together. Once the sand is blended together, it cannot be separated. Just as the sand cannot be separated, your friends and your family are here today to witness your love never separating. By blending these sands together, we are recognizing the importance of blending two families together. May you always honor and protect your family. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Amen. You may pour your sands together.
It is mixed colors, yes.
There you go. This is a signature part that I use at every wedding that I officiate, and I have officiated many. This is the time I have a charge to the family and friends. Beloved friends and family, it was both a blessing and a privilege for you to be here. Now my question is to you, will you commit to being fully vested in encouraging this beautiful couple that when the rainy days of married life comes, and maybe some of you out there know about the rainy days of marriage, that you will also pray that what God placed together will remain so, fully persuaded that this day was ordained before the beginning of time. And if you, friends and family, agree to that charge, then would you say as one corporate body, we will?
We will.
Eternal God, creator and preserver of all mankind, giver of all spiritual grace and author of everlasting life, send thy blessing upon this couple. Bless them that they live faithfully together and keep their vows and covenant between them. May they remain in perfect peace together according to thy will, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And now, by the power invested in me by the state of New York, and perhaps more importantly, the authority of God, I pronounce as blessed and affirmed in sacred holy matrimony, Mrs. and Mrs. Robin and Patrice Shelton Davis. You may kiss your bride.
DJ, spin that.
You can wait for your music.
I was thinking,
okay. You're mad now.